Next up on the list of live food culture videos, we have vinegar eels. These are small aquatic nematodes, just like microworms, but with some distinct advantages. First, they won't drown in your aquarium and can stay alive in the water column for up to a week. Second, they swim in the middle and upper water column, which makes them perfect for small fish fry that feed from those areas rather than from the bottom. Now, these are called vinegar eels because they can live in vinegar and other acidic environments, not because they must live in vinegar. If they had to live in vinegar, then they wouldn't survive so long in the aquarium. If they die before being eaten, it's probably for lack of food. The advantage to culturing them in vinegar comes from the way that acid slows the growth of bacteria that would cause their food source to rot. I'll talk a bit about that later, but for now, let's make a culture. So the good news is, this might be the easiest live food culture that I'm going to show you. You can see a theme here. I do love the deli cups. That's one quart right there. Got a lid with some holes poked in it and a few fresh slices of apple. Okay, so half and half dechlorinated water and apple cider vinegar. Add apples. Let's just say this is your starter culture. I believe I bought mine from a company called insectsales.com. Wasn't very expensive. So there's some live vinegar eels in here. Add those. Put a lid on it. Store them in the dark. Keep them at room temperature. If you're happy, they're happy. And you're done. Just wait. It might take a few weeks for the population to really explode, but pretty soon, they'll have a thriving culture. I'll zoom in on one here and show you what it looks like. Now, as always, I recommend having some redundancy in your cultures. When you get your starter mailed to you, you want to split that up and probably get a few going so that if anything bad happens to one, you've got backups. Nothing bad is likely to happen, but just in case, it's always a good idea. This one has been going for, oh, I don't know, probably 2 weeks, and you can see there's plenty in here. They grow pretty quickly. So when it comes time to actually extract and feed these to your fish, it can get a little more complicated, but really just as complicated as you want it to be. Now, if you've seen instructionals on this anywhere else, you've probably seen this method recommended here, where you culture your vinegar eels in one container and then use another to actually feed them when it's time. And you'll see it recommended to use something with a long neck to which you can shove down to the bottom a layer of filter floss and then fill up the neck above it with pure water. And the vinegar eels, wanting to be close to the surface, will swim through the filter floss and hang out up there. You can just take a pipette, reach in there, you know, suck them out, and they're good to go. Now, I don't have the patience for this most often. I also have this odd paranoia of removing this filter floss without accidentally knocking it down here and losing it. So I've never personally opted to do that, but it's mostly because of my impatience. All I do is I just pour it into a small coffee filter and rinse them, and then rinse that coffee filter off in some pure water and then dump that in with my fish. It doesn't take long. The only downside is that it does consume some of the water and apple cider vinegar mixture, but it's very cheap and I keep gallons of it pre-mixed, so it doesn't bother me. My method also has the advantage of ensuring that I'm doing a water change in here, which may or may not affect the longevity. Might possibly increase it, but I don't know. So like I said earlier, the vinegar preserves the food source. Think of this just like pickles or something else that's stored in vinegar. These apples are not going to break down very quickly, and they will provide a continuous food source for bacteria. The bacteria is actually what the vinegar eels are going to eat. So given how much food is here in these apples and how slowly it's going to break down, you can expect a culture to last for 6 months, a year, maybe even longer than that without really needing maintenance. And even then, all you would have to do is take some of your culture and add it to a fresh culture with fresh apple slices. Other than that, it should be no trouble to maintain. The signs that you would want to change over to a new culture would be that the water is becoming excessively cloudy and maybe there's a population decline, but really we're talking about very, very low maintenance. They're also very productive. So one recommendation I would offer: if you keep one of these off to the side for feeding, you would end up transferring your culture into here, putting in the filter floss, and then waiting a period of time for the vinegar eels to rise to the top. But you can also grow them in here. That's what I did first. I bought a couple of these at a craft store, and I actually cultured them in here. And if you do, that's fine. Just do one thing. Don't keep this water level right here. Keep it down here somewhere. you want to maximize the surface area of water with air. They seem to really need some good oxygenation. So don't clog this up too much. If you use something to keep bugs out of it, make sure that there still is some good airflow, and then lower that water level down. I noticed that I was having a really hard time getting this culture to catch on and really boom in population until I poured some off for one reason or another, lowered the water level, and then came back just days later and they had tripled, quadrupled in population. It was pretty remarkable. So that's my observation. Keep that low, give them plenty of air to breathe. Over here in these cultures, there's tons of surface area, so no worries there. I think that's why my most recent redundant cultures have increased in population so dramatically, so quickly. So yeah, this is an easy one. Great for your fish. Good luck. Bye.